It's a good thing I only got into a minute or so of this before I realized that the sound wasn't working. Hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Play Pokemon Emerald Part 2! So, in this part, we shall do everything. Every single thing. No. So I'm going to go over natures a little bit this time. Because, as you can see, Treecko has a bold nature. And I don't think I went over those last time, what they actually do. Natures, there are quite a few of them. 26, I think? Off the top of my head. I don't know if that's correct or not. But anyway, the point is, they're quite a number. And they affect their stats in various ways, depending on the nature. But basically, either they won't affect the stats at all, neutral natures, or they will increase one stat and decrease another by 10% each. So bold nature actually increases defense by 10% and attack, it decreases by 10%. Defense increases if I didn't... I don't know. Either way. If you have Pokemon with you, then you're an official Pokemon trainer. You can't say no to my challenge. No. Oh. Never mind. Doesn't work. Curses! The microphone doesn't work. What? Youngster Calvin wants to battle. Or would like to battle. I think he said wants to battle in the older ones. I don't know. I do not remember. So, either way, yeah, it's not a terrible nature. Defense is always nice, and I'm not going to be using attack a whole lot. There are obviously much better natures, but I'm not going to be worrying about that too much in this playthrough. Normally I would, but no, I'm not going to this time. I'm not going to go and catch that one Pokemon with the perfect stats and the perfect nature and all that. That just takes away too much time. And effort. And I do not fear like doing all that. Plus, it would probably be incredibly lame to watch, slash, just cut to me catching some perfectly found Pokemon. Perfectly found. It's found like any others. Anyway. That's not what I wanted to find. So from here on, after this battle, I shall be cutting all the random Pokemon battles in the grass, unless there's something special about them. Say if there is a Pokemon that we haven't seen yet, or something that I'm going to catch, perhaps. Perhaps. So, yes, look forward to that, I guess. I don't know why you would be looking for that. They'll be cut out unless they're special, okay? That's the point. Man, I feel like this part is going to have a lot of me just explaining how things are going to go. So here we have an optional trainer, because as you can see down here, you can go random. However, I'm going to fight him, but I'm going to do... I'm not going to necessarily specifically show the optional trainers. I will show all the required trainers, but not necessarily all the optional trainers. So, unless he has something special, I'll meet you at the end. Well, I guess I'll do his voice. Alright, Smith. I'll take you on with my bug Pokemon! They basically had the same voice as the last trainer. And Treecko grew to level 9. And got some nice, some pretty nice stat increases. So, as you can see, the stats increase differently for each stat and each different level. Depending on nature, depending on the Pokemon, because each Pokemon has different stat growths and all that good stuff. I'll probably get into that more later. Anyway, meet you at the end. Player defeated Bugcatcher Rick, and we took his money. He stole his money. It's probably his lunch money, too. Yo, you're not a trainer. Oh no! Oh hey! Well, this is something I actually wanted to show. Zigzagoon! Something that we obviously have seen before several times. But this one is different. Well, this particular one isn't any different than the others. But what I'm... I was gonna say what I'm going to be doing is different, but nah, I guess it is. I'm going to be catching it. And not necessarily to use on my team. I'm not planning on using a Zigzagoon or its evolution. Yes, they evolve. They grow stronger. Who have thought? But I am going to be using it nonetheless, not as a team member necessarily. Rubbing its nose against the ground, it always wanders back and forth in search of something, is distinguished by the zigzag footprints it leaves. Okay then. No, I don't. So here's another optional trainer find.
To do just become a trainer, we'll both be good.
See you at the end. By the way, Trico grew to level 10! So yes, that's the thing that happened.
I called you because I thought I could beat you.
You didn't call me, you just talked to me. Yeah, actually you just ran up to me and started yapping at me. Yapping, not really yapping. I suppose more just, yeah, talking I guess would be an accurate statement. And so we have the introduction of berries. Well, not really introduction. They were in the last generation, Generation 2. However, I say last generation in terms of this game, not in terms of in general. But so here we have berries, and you can use them outside battle. But you can also, as it says, hold the items. Well, you can't, but your Pokemon can. So you can actually give this item to a Pokemon. And after a certain point, for the orange berries, where it restores 10 HP, at a certain point it'll use it and to restore 10 HP. Pekka berry, if it's poisoned, it'll use it. So they're pretty cool. Over here we have more grass. Yeah, more grass. Cool. Down here we do have an item though, which I should be getting. It is a potion, which is lovely. More health is always lovely. Ah, here we have a Lotad. This is a grass and water type. It's actually really cool. I like Lotad a lot. Well, I don't like Lotad necessarily. Lotad is actually pretty awful. But its evolution, its final evolution, is actually really awesome. Yeah, it's probably one of my favorite grass types. But it's a really good special attacker slash staller, because it's got some really nice grass moves for stalling and regenerating its health and everything, as well as some really nice, what are they called? Water type moves, yes, for doing lots of damage. So, it's especially good with Rain Dance or something like that. If you would like to go with the weather effect teams. So, I'm going to go challenge this trainer, Trick. And once I'm done fighting her, I'll meet you back exactly here. So this trainer has a Shroomish, which is a grass type Pokemon, and it can be a bit of a pain to fight because it has the ability Effect Spore. If you hit it with a physical type move, there is a chance that you will get affected by it. What it does is it gives you a random status ailment between sleep, paralysis, and poison. So that's kind of lame. So if you can, hit it with non-physical moves, and yes, I was hitting it with Pound, but since it's grass, Absorb isn't going to do anything against it, really. So we're in Pelleberg City. Wasn't there some important here? Maybe it's in the water. It's like Loch Ness. My face is reflected in the water. It's a shining grin full of hope. Or could it be a look of somber silence struggling with fear? What do you see reflected in your face? Eyes. That's about it. I can understand, I guess, why you're having trouble figuring out whether that's a grin or not, because you can't actually see your mouth, because you don't really have a mouth. But anyway. Oh hey, Jim, we should go fight people! Oh wait, Norman, isn't that our dad? I'm pretty sure it's our dad. Hey dad, what's up? Hmm? Well, if it isn't Joel! So you're all finished moving in? I'm surprised that you managed to get here by yourself. Oh, I see. You're with your Pokemon. Then I guess you're going to become a trainer like me, Joel. I already am. Well, that's great news. I'll be looking forward to it.
And I'd like to get a Pokemon, please?
You're Wally, right? Right?
I'm going to stay with my relatives in Verdantir Town. I thought I would be lonely by myself, so I wanted to take a Pokemon along. But I've never caught a Pokemon before. I don't know how.
I see. Joel, you heard that, right? Yes. Go with Wally and make sure that he safely catches Pokemon. Wally, here, I'll loan you my Pokemon. Wally received a Zigzagoon.
Oh wow, a Pokemon.
I'll give you a Pokeball too. Go for it. Wally received a Pokeball.
Oh wow, thank you. Joel, would you really come with me?
Do I have to? I don't really want to. The music already tells me what this is. It's a tutorial on how to catch Pokemon.
Joel, Pokemon hide in tall grass like this, don't they? Please watch me and see if I can catch one properly. Whoa!
Good night. Yes, a tutorial. I like how Gold and Silver and Crystal did. You could choose whether you wanted to do the tutorial or not. And I'm controlling this. I can't do anything but watch him and shake my head. Oh well. It's a randomly leveled Zigzagoon. I'm just gonna say that. It's just, usually you find either like level 2 or level 5 or something like that. It's just a level 7 Zigzagoon. Why? You threw out a bow now, right? Yeah. But it's just, he's so randomly leveled. Why is it level 7? But whatever. It is what it is, what it is. By the way, this Ralts is interesting. It's a psychic Pokemon, and it's pretty cool. Although it only has one attack when you get Azeralts like that level. Which is actually that Growl that we saw, so it actually can't attack.
I did! It's my Pokemon! Joel, thank you! Let's go back to the gym!
Okay. So, did it work out?
Thank you, yes it did! Here's your Pokemon back! Joel, thank you for coming along with me!
Why would you face me when you talk then?
You two are why I was able to catch my Pokemon! I promise I'll take really good care of it! Oh, my mom's waiting for me, so I have to go! Bye, Joel!
Bye. Now, Joel, if you want to become a strong trainer, here's my advice. Head for Rustboro City, beyond this town. There you should challenge the gym leader, Roxanne. After her, go to the other Pokemon gyms and defeat their leaders. Collect badges from them. Understood? Of course, I'm a gym leader too. We'll battle one day, Joel. That's only after you become stronger. Ha 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 ha. Why can't I fight you now? I'm sure if I use enough potions, I can beat you. I'm sure. What's this? Excuse me? Let me guess. From the way you're dressed, are you a Pokemon trainer? Well, maybe not. Your clothes aren't all that dirty. You're either a rookie trainer, or maybe just an ordinary kid. They do exist, you know? I'm roaming in the land in search of talented trainers. I'm sorry to have taken your time. Well, that was rude. Thank you, sir, for being rude. What do you have to say? Oh no, I'm not a trainer. But that's right, if trainers lock eyes, it's a challenge to battle. Or romantic. If you don't want to battle, stay out of their sight. Wow, they're like schoolyard bullies.
If I see you coming around here, I'm gonna fight you. This guy's obviously optional, so I shall see you at the end. Leaving footprints in the sand is so fun.
Treecko grew to level 11 and got stats, which is of course what we want, and learn Quick Attack. Cool.
Excellent. Ah, and he's about to use a new Pokemon that we have not seen yet, Seedot. Another grass type, but it is annoying to fight at this level because it knows Bide. Oh dear. It's biding its time. Basically what Bide does is it stores energy for a couple turns, and any damage that it took during those turns while storing up energy, when it releases, well, it didn't have any damage on it. It didn't gain damage while it was biding its time, so it didn't do anything. But if it has had damage during that time, then it deals out double that amount of damage when it releases it, so it can be nasty if you're not careful about it. So it's also really tough physically, so it's kind of a pain at this level.
Wow, I got seen in my runners, they're all gritty.
That's nice. No, give me your money.
Give me your money.
Herm, a boat. That's pretty sweet. It's a pretty sweet boat you got there, even though it's about as big as I am.
Ah, berries! Berries! I love berries! You're so delicious!
Even though I haven't used one yet, but nonetheless. Ah, more Orin and Pekka berries. It's a pity that we don't have any more berries. But oh well, these are still useful. There are actually a ton of berries in this game, of all kinds of varieties.
You must have been fated to meet. May I ask you for a Pokemon battle? For a battle of any kind?
No!
Yes. Certain trainers will use healing items. Annoyingly, usually it's rich people or gym leaders. Most average trainers don't actually use items, but like the ladies and rich boys, they like to use items because they have so much money. It's quite a quandary. You have to basically beat their Pokemon twice. It's kind of annoying. But nonetheless, we have defeated it. And perhaps gained the level? Question mark? Yes, level 12! And didn't gain a whole lot, but nonetheless, it is a level.
Oh my.
Yeah, fortunately, ladies and rich boys, they give you a lot of money. A lot. So I believe that this should be a good time to cut off right here, right before we get to some exciting. Yeah. Aw, yeah. So, until next time, I shall bid you... Saving game. I shall bid you farewell.